Hello, Asta here, and welcome back to my channel. Today I have a new backup product, and it definitely wasn't what I was expecting. So when I first got this product, I actually had an idea that this will be a nice tinted moisturizer, and this is what I was looking for every day. That moisturizer with loads of skin benefits in it, as well as some coverage. And the reason why I had it in my mind was because it does say it is a light shifter dewing tint tinted moisturizer. This moisturizer comes in 8 colors only, and it was 30 euro on coldbeauty.com, but on sephora.com it's also $30. So you get 30 mils in it, or 1 fluid ounce, and this is a normal amount that most foundations come as well. So this moisturizer promised to give weightless coverage and lit from within kind of look on the skin. It actually is infused with some amazing skincare ingredients. Few of those are squalane that nourishes the skin, vitamin E that is a huge antioxidant to protect your skin from everyday pollution, from that blue light, and that's why I was very interested specifically because it protects from the blue light. I'm on my phone and on my computer nearly, I don't know, 20 hours a day, so I was like, this is really, really promising. And as most of skin products these days, this tinted moisturizer also contains hyaluronic acid for that hydration of your skin. So it comes in this little kind of plasticky tube. You can squeeze the product out. I'm gonna show you how that looks. Now I must say, when I did that first, when it came, I was very surprised because it looks so illuminating. Literally, can you see? And it has a nice kind of consistency as well. It's not too runny, but not too thick. So I'm very excited to try it on. So I don't have anything on my face at the minute, just my moisturizer from this morning, the SPF moisturizer. This one doesn't have an SPF. Let's apply that onto my face. I'm gonna take whatever I squeezed out and I'm gonna apply that on the side of my face. So I got color Light Seeker 2.5. It applies really, really easily, like your normal moisturizer, I suppose. It does give a nice, kind of very illuminating finish to the skin, I must say. This is not what I was expecting. In terms of coverage, it doesn't give any coverage whatsoever. The only thing it does give a nice kind of illumination to the skin. It actually really reminds me of the Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Flawless Filter or the NARS Skin Booster. So I'm gonna take a little bit more of that product and I'm gonna try and see if I can build the coverage. On their website, it says to use your fingers to apply it, like just like you would apply your moisturizer. When you first kind of lay it on your skin, it has that nice tint to the product, but then once you kind of work it into your skin, it kind of disappears and absorbs into the skin. It does feel tacky, doesn't seem to dry, to touch proof. I don't think you can really build up the coverage though. You know what? I'm really tempted to compare that to Hollywood Flawless Filter. So on this side, I'm going to apply Hollywood Flawless Filter. This is color 3 medium. We'll see if it's actually similar or I'm just imagining it. Yeah, taking some of that filter thing. Color-wise, I think it's very, very close as far as the tint color. You know what? The Charlotte one is actually a little bit more illuminating again. Can you see the difference? So this is the Hollywood Flawless Filter and this is the Becca Light Shifter. Gives pretty much a similar effect to the skin, but right off the bat, I can see that the Charlotte Tilbury one, I think it does do better job evening out the skin tone and obviously more dewy looking, but it's very, very similar. The Flawless Filter definitely has more illuminating particles in it. It definitely feels more illuminating on the skin than the Becca. Therefore, that's why sometimes I don't wear Hollywood Flawless Filter on its own every day, because this level of illumination on my skin, I don't like. I feel it's a bit too much. It does look amazing underneath the foundation, but on its own, I feel it's too much. On the other hand, the Becca Light Shifter, it does give you that lit from within effect, but it's not over the top. I feel like I'm less greasy looking wearing this tinted moisturizer than the Hollywood Flawless Filter. So even though they are quite similar products, Hollywood Flawless Filter is definitely more illuminating. I was just expecting a little bit more coverage out of this. That's why I'm a bit shocked, because I did think it's gonna have some sort of color that would even out my skin tone. Becca actually released a pressed powder to use with this tinted moisturizer. I didn't get get it. I have so many powders, I don't need another one. But I suppose if you use this product and you want a little bit of that coverage, you can sure use some sort of pressed powder or a concealer to conceal that problem areas. And then, you know, if you have relatively good skin and you're happy with how your skin looks, you can definitely use this just on its own or with a little touches and help from concealers or pressed powders. Becca is such a great brand. It's gluten-free, cruelty-free, and vegan. And just on Wednesday, I discovered that this brand is shutting their doors because of COVID. They closing their business, and I was so sad because Becca company makes such an amazing product, and it's so sad to see big brands like that go because of this pandemic in the world. So if you use any of Becca products and you love something in particular, make sure to get it because they are leaving the market in September. So before that, if you need anything, try to get it online or in the shops because sadly Becca will be gone. So I have finished the rest of my makeup, and what can I say? It doesn't give you any coverage at all. It doesn't give you any color. Well, for me, it doesn't. It does have a nice illuminating finish to the skin. So I suppose for the days when you don't want to wear makeup, but you want your skin to look a little bit more glowy, a little bit more illuminating, this is a nice product to use. I will definitely use it. Even underneath the foundation, you can still see a little bit of that illuminating coming through. From the very start, it's not what I was expecting. I wanted this very light coverage. Unfortunately, this didn't give it to me, but overall, I'm very happy I tried this Becca product. So I hope it's been helpful. Thank you so much for trying this out together with me today. And as always, please give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed today's video. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you all next week.